Value assurance. How can we make sure that we are able to deliver what we promise to deliver? And what activities should we undertake? Let's start first by looking back at how value is developed throughout the project lifecycle. You've seen this diagram before. A project that's well defined in the front-end phase of a project has a good starting point for becoming successful, assuming that the later project phases of execution and operation are also managed well. An ill-defined project, however, can never be turned around into a very successful one. So the potential of value realization is created in the early project phase. Apart from a stage-gate approach and a well-motivated team, what do we need? How to start? Typically, it helps trying to break down the overall assignment into smaller pieces, a work breakdown structure. It defines the hierarchical decomposition of tasks and subtasks in the project. You would make a high-level WBS at the very beginning of the project and only fill in the details as the project matures. Next to this WBS, a product breakdown structure could be used. A PBS is based on products and defines the hierarchy of products and subproducts rather than tasks and subtasks in a WBS. In practice, most often a combination is used, and it's just indicated with WBS. This is also the case in this example of the offshore wind park. The work package consists of activities, but the level below you can recognize products as well. For example, the wind turbine generator in the first work package, or the different permits in the second work package. In our project, we need the standard project management activities, following, for example, the project management body of knowledge focus areas. It's about scope management within the boundaries of time, cost, and quality, not to forget about risk management. Next to these, we need to manage our stakeholders. We need to manage communications, the human resources, and the procurement. And last but not least, it's about the integration thereof and the integration of the different elements of the work breakdown structure. These activities are performed following a plan, do, check, act cycle. Think before act and check what you've done and adjust accordingly. It starts writing a plan and getting approval for the plan. Without this plan, you do not have an agreed baseline. It doesn't mean you cannot deviate from the plan, but it does mean that you should communicate about any changes to this plan and also carefully consider possible consequences of those changes. So a plan needs to be written. Before detailing the ingredients of the plan, let's talk about the type of activities to be performed and to what extent we should spend our efforts in the early project phases. Spending efforts in the early project phases pays off, but not unlimited. At some point, you can keep on spending resources without obtaining extra benefits. You actually have crossed the optimal solution. Compare the five fictive cases. All cases are about the same project, but with different investments in terms of effort and different overall benefits. Which of the cases indicates the optimal solution? Indeed, it's case three. The benefits clearly increase with increasing efforts, but in case three, the investments equal the benefits. Spending even more resources in front-end does not increase the benefits in case four and case five. Hence, be aware not to invest too much. But how could we decide what we have to invest in the management of our projects? Could this be different for different types of projects? Here, some earlier mentioned project examples are shown. The bridge, the highly innovative product development, the renovation of a plant, or simply moving house. Different types of projects, but all realized with help of a project management approach and project management activities. The amount of application will differ per project. In one project, risk management will be a daily activity with top priority, whereas in another project, risk management is done on a weekly or monthly basis. In order to decide what project management activities have to be performed and to what extent, in our research, we proposed the TOE complexity framework to characterize projects. This TOE framework distinguishes 47 potential complexity sources clustered in three categories: T, technical; O, organizational; and E, external. Based upon the complexities you expect in the project, you could select which project management activities should get high priority. Take again the example of risk management. In case of a project where you expect high technical risk, it's more likely and advisable to give top priority to risk management activities. The complexity footprint of a project that will change during the different project phases can also be used to select the so-called VIPs. VIP, it's an acronym for Value Improving Practices. The process industry realized that application of standard project management activities would not be sufficient with increasingly complex projects. Therefore, so-called Value Improving Practices, VIPs, VIPs, were defined. The construction industry did the same by identifying best practices. The best practices and the VIPs are slightly different, but both serve the same purpose, increasing the value of projects, value for money. If you would blindly apply as much value improving practices as you can think of, just as a tick the box exercise, rather than grabbing the real essentials, it most probably will not work. From our research, for example, it was shown that project managers did recognize the importance of risk management, but at the same time, they considered the application of it as a been there, done that, once in a lifetime exercise. So they were just ticking boxes, only once in the project, instead of identifying the relevant risk on a more repetitive basis. No surprise what happens then. When you're selecting the VIPs and the way you're going to apply them in your project, please do not forget the cooperation between all parties involved. Performing, for example, a joint goal-setting workshop with owner and contractor representatives available enables short communication lines, and it helps development of a trust relation, crucial for later project success. Now we have talked about the standard project management activities and the so-called value improving practices, VIPs, we should go back to the plan. The plan is the document that acts as the backbone of your project. Here everything comes together. It includes the answers to the why, the what, the who and the when questions about the project. It details which activities and value improving practices will be applied in the project and how delivery of value is assured. There are various names around for various types of plans used in different project phases. Whether it's called a project initiation document, a project charter, a project mandate, or a project implementation plan, the objective of the plan should be that it creates a baseline for the project. In our MOOC, we focus on the execution plan. We provide you with a guideline for the content of the project execution plan. In the project execution plan, we start with a brief sketch of the project context in the introduction part. Next, the objective of the project is presented, followed by an opportunity statement. In the detailed scope of work, it's defined what's part and what's not part of the project. How to care about health, safety, and environment is described next. The project organization and governance are addressed, as well as the selected contracting strategy. A risk register is also part of the project execution plan, followed by the cost and schedule estimates. A link to the business case is made in the economical evaluation section. The project management approach is detailed and also attention is paid towards project control and progress reporting. And last but not least, the project execution plan describes how to evaluate and make sure that lessons are learned and captured and exploited. And that brings me to today's final slide. Despite all project management activities and VIPs presented today, please carefully check still, what could work best for your specific project? You expect high technical risk? Rather invest in thorough risk management. You expect complexities in resourcing? Act upfront. Dare to adjust your project management strategies to your context. One size does not fit all.